Hey there, welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to discuss about monkey fever. Monkey fever is also known as Kyasanur forest disease or KFD. It is caused by a highly dangerous virus called KFD virus and belongs to the family Flaviviridae. So how does this virus enter the monkeys and from there to humans? It is through a forest tick called Haemaphysalis spinigera. To make the picture more clear, we have to see the life cycle of this dangerous tick. The eggs hatch into thousands of larvae. They are picked up by small animals and birds. The fed larvae drop to the ground, molt to nymphs, and seek hosts again, small animals and monkeys. When local residents visit the forest to collect firewood or honey, they get infected by these nymphs. Sometimes the ticks drop again and molt to adults and then attach to larger animals like cattle. Monkey deaths are regarded as the first signs of approaching human infection. It is manifested as an epizootic outbreak among monkeys, hence the name monkey fever. It's an infectious bleeding disease, bleeding from the nose, from the mouth and from gastrointestinal tract. So it's also known as viral hemorrhagic fever. Also high fever, frontal headaches, vomiting, muscle stiffness, absence of reflexes, mental disturbances are part of the symptoms. Research using mice models found that KFD virus replicated primarily in brain cells, and neuropathetic symptoms are a result of this. An affected person may recover in 2 weeks' time, but convalescent period is typically long, taking months, due to muscle aches, weakness, and inability to engage in physical activities. Luckily, no person-to-person transmission has been observed. Monkey fever was identified in 1957 in Kyasanur forest, Shimoga district, Karnataka, India, and it was isolated from a sick monkey. For decades, it was confined to the forest of Shimoga. The last 5 years, it has spread along the forests of Karnataka to neighboring states, especially the western gut regions of Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Goa, and Maharashtra. The disease used to recur every year during the summer months, taking lives from communities that reside in the forest area. This year, 146 cases were reported in Shimoga, including 2 deaths. Last year, it was 445 cases and 23 deaths. In Kerala this year, till date, 24 cases have been reported, 19 recovered and 3 died in Wayanad district. Last year, 2 people died of the disease. In 2014-15, 11 people died of the same. Doctors may recommend blood work to determine the monkey fever virus, which includes ELISA and PCR tests. Till date, there is no definite treatment available for monkey fever. It is recommended to seek immediate medical attention. Patients are generally given intravenous fluid therapy to replace the lost fluids. Necessary protective measures are also taken to prevent and control hemorrhagic bleeding. Complete rest and hydration are also part of the treatment. Preventive measures include tick control oils like DMP, dimethyl phthalate, that was distributed through ASHA workers in early September 2019 as a tick repellent. Protective clothing is also part of the tick control. Since 1990, in all endemic areas of Karnataka, state government has initiated vaccination campaigns using formalin inactivated tissue culture vaccine. Vaccination is usually carried out within a range of 5 kilometers of affected area. 2 doses of the vaccine are administered to individuals between 7 to 65 years at an interval of 1 month, followed by periodic boosters after 6 to 9 months for 5 years. Owing to fears that KFD vaccine will result in loss of hair, muscle pain, many people in rural areas have been showing reluctance to get themselves vaccinated. Multiple doses are also an issue for them. To control monkey fever, systemic efforts are needed to improve the current vaccine and its coverage. As of today in Wayanad, the district administration has implemented lockdown model isolation, which is another step to keep villagers away from the forest during these months.